When you think about power lines, you probably think of something like this. Ugly megastructures that cut through nature in order to provide the power we all consume. But what if I told you that these scars in the landscape could not only be integrated into nature, but actually boost biodiversity, bring back endangered species, and become literal insect highways? By its sheer scale, the unused land that exists underneath power lines presents possibly the biggest rewilding opportunity in the world. And there's one organization that is tapping into this immense potential and showing the way forward. Of course, we wanted to bring support. So we sent Feely from Planet Wild to Switzerland to help pioneer three incredible ways of transforming a power line and turn this barren land into a wildlife paradise. We're Planet Wild. Welcome to Mission 15.
In industrialized countries all over the world, nature has been squeezed out to make room for human infrastructure and agriculture, and it's native animal and plant species that are paying the price. Meanwhile, the land underneath this power line is completely unused. In fact, everything that stood here has just been cleared by chainsaws. Just this one power line from where I'm standing right here to Basel creates about 15 hectares of unused space. That's the same as 21 soccer fields or, if you prefer, 28 American football fields. But why is the space kept barren like this? Power lines are super sensitive. If a tree were to touch this, the whole city of Basel would lose power. I'm not joking, that actually happens. So to build power lines, you have to clear huge areas of land to make sure this doesn't happen. And now there's just nothing. No animals, no plants, no biodiversity, just the low, continuous hum of electricity.
But of course, this immense web of power is needed to feed our cities, towns, and industry. It connects our societies and it connects us to each other. The total length of the global power network is estimated at around 100 million kilometers. That's about two-thirds the way to the sun. Without power lines, you wouldn't be able to use your lights, your fridge, your phone. You wouldn't even be able to watch this video. And in the future, we'll need even more of them, because the energy transition necessary to reach net zero requires more decentralized energy production, therefore adding an extra 30% in length to the existing grid. Most of that grid is made up of small cables connecting to our houses. But there's also the big high-voltage transmission lines that are connecting our cities to power plants. If these go through open fields or grassland, their effect on the land remains relatively limited. But the parts that cut through forests create large areas of unused land like this that don't benefit anyone. So they could technically be used for rewilding. Well, there's no official numbers on this. We did some calculations and found out that in Europe alone, there are approximately 500,000 hectares or almost 1 million football fields of deforested land directly underneath power lines. A gigantic opportunity that has been hiding in plain sight. Until now.
If I walk through nature and see power lines, it's always, how could we improve the situation here?
This is Thomas. He used to work as a statistician, sitting behind a computer crunching numbers. But eventually he quit to commit his life to nature protection and join Pro Natura, Switzerland's oldest environmental organization with over 100 years of track record. Now, together with his team, Thomas has developed a three-part plan to turn this forgotten land into an oasis for biodiversity that will bring back buzzing life and benefit the larger ecosystem. This transformation was made possible because of people just like you, because Planet Wild is entirely community-funded. Every month, we go on a mission to bring back endangered species, clean up oceans, or rewild entire landscapes. The bigger our community grows, the bigger these missions will get. So, let's get to work. First, we're creating an insect highway. Normally, the area underneath power lines gets completely cleared, only to be overgrown quickly by a few dominant species. This means plant and insect diversity stays incredibly low. Instead, Thomas and his team are performing a kind of layered haircut, carefully creating a more gradual dip in vegetation, introducing a diverse mix of small and mid-sized plants that in turn will attract a rich insect population.
Okay, where should we put it?
I think here's a good spot. Yes.
Soon this tree is going to produce flowers, and wild bees and butterflies are going to stop here to feed and rest. Take this beautiful creature, for example, the peacock butterfly. Like many other insects, it's threatened by something called population fragmentation. This happens when cities, large monocultures, or commercial forests become barriers that prevent a population from mixing with others of its kind. But now, our long-stretched biodiverse meadow is creating a pathway to connect all kinds of distant populations. Literally a highway for bees, bugs, and butterflies. But this doesn't only benefit the insects. Because the peacock butterfly acts as a pollinator, it carries genes from the flowers at one end of the highway to the other. So the meadow is connecting butterfly and plant populations that would have been completely separated if the power lines were not here.
Now we turn something negative, this power line, into something very positive. Many insects and butterflies can pass here that would not even have been possible to fly here a few years ago. I mean, it's all about coexistence. We take so much from nature, including the power that flows into these cables. So it's up to us to give something back.
This shift in perspective is at the core of the pioneer work that Thomas's team is doing. And it's these kind of initiatives where we feel that our community funding can provide the biggest lever. So we chipped in with 25,000 euros to help Thomas and his team reach their goal of rewilding 30 hectares of power lines in a pilot project that will unlock even more funding in the future and provide an example to be copied worldwide. And this brings us to the second part of Thomas' ambitious plan.
Okay, so this might look like a pile of rocks. And, well, okay, it is. But I promise, it's not just any pile of rocks. Thomas and his team have built dozens of these along the power lines because they're home to a very charming guest. And today, we're setting up wildlife cameras to show just how beneficial they are. So who exactly is hiding in these rock shelters? Weasels! Weasels are often exposed to predators, especially in this open farmland around here. So Thomas and his team have built dozens of these rock shelters as safe havens directly underneath the pylons. With the weasels taken care of, now let's get to my favorite part, creating wildlife ponds. By the way, you can become a part of these missions yourself and join the Planet Wild community. As a backer, you'll be supporting transformational projects like this one, and you'll get access to our team Discord, behind-the-scenes footage, mission debriefs, regular updates, and so much more. There's a link in the description. Now for part three. To complete the transformation, the team here are also creating a network of ponds, each one serving as an oasis for amphibians and reptiles to breed, raise their young, or just have a drink. And a big fan of this idea is the midwife toad, which gets its name from a unique behavior.
It's a very special toad. The male takes the eggs on his back and brings it into the water. So we have the pond for reproduction and the stone structure where they live in. And in Swiss German we call it Glöcklifrosch because they make such a special noise when they're calling each other.
This curious species is threatened by the severe lack of aquatic space left in the landscape. So the Planet Wild community has stepped up again to provide a new, beautiful wildlife pond to further extend the habitat of the Glöcklifrosch and other amphibians. And if you want to see much more of those, I think you'll like our next mission, so don't forget to subscribe. Thomas is using this place to inspire the next generation of wildlife protectors. So he invited some special guests to help build these ponds under the power lines.
I'm really proud that me and my classmate did this. I know that we did something good, and I hope that animals can live here and can be safe.
Seeing the school kids from a local school engaging with this site is really special for me. Then the next generation, no? And with this experience that they can collect now, I'm sure they will find many more opportunities in the future to bring back biodiversity to sites like this.
Now, with the insect highway, the rock shelters, and the wildlife ponds, this project is like a seed being planted. And now I can't help but imagine a future where projects like this sprout up all over the world. So what to do next? Sign up to Planet Wild with the link in the description or the QR code over here. Or watch another video over here.